ideas are what we actually give students. So when we at Startup Village have like a batch of like 100 teams, 90 students pick ideas we give. And 10 students or 10 teams pick up their own original ideas. And that's the only way we figured out to go into this and solve this. Now once the student learns the idea, and these are all industry validated ideas. So usually, for example, if you start ricemandi.com, okay, there is no market for that because Flipkart has already can easily add one more segment saying rice. So students don't know how to evaluate market potential. So they go wrong in all of these things, right? These industry evaluated ideas have market potential. Then it's about execution and finding out whether it works or not. In my experience, all first ideas fail. Okay, very rarely do you come up with the Facebook sort of idea. First time founders who are in engineering college succeed in their fourth idea. So in the first three ideas you fail, and then what happens is your ego actually comes down a lot. So smart students think I code, I build product, customer will buy. Not happening. Like absolutely not happening, right? But now because they've learned why it is not happening, they start thinking again. In the fourth idea is when they start figuring out what's the correct thing. And the difference here is they talk to the customer. If you engineer something without talking to a customer, there is nobody to buy. If there is nobody to buy, there is no profits at the end of the day because there is no revenues. So in college, we don't look at it this way, right? That's the whole difference. So the answer to this is you need to leverage incubators, accelerators, or hackathons, where this idea pool is flying around. The Smart India hackathons, the same, you know, railways thing. So the change is happening. So it is very true, students don't have ideas. The reason for it now you know. The solutions which currently we are doing is industry people supply ideas, students execute, they fail. Absolutely okay, you become at least now a better engineer. But then students pick up the next idea and the next idea. By the fourth idea, two things are clear. Okay. One, the student figures out, I really want to be an entrepreneur. All the students figure out, I should not be an entrepreneur. This is a very important discovery because the journey of an entrepreneur is pain, depression, the roller coaster of emotions of highs and lows. You have more bad days than good days, right? And only when you go through that pain, do you mature as an individual. And only when you mature as an individual, do you really have the leadership, do you really overcome fear of failure, and then you actually truly decide, I want to be an entrepreneur. And in this country, everything that is supposed to take 5 years will take 10 years. So you decide, I will fight it out for 10 years, and then you become successful. Like Narayana Murthy said, no, it took Infosys 25 years to become an overnight success. Right? So it will take time. So some students will figure this out, and then decide, after getting job offers saying, I am now fully confident to be an entrepreneur. And I know this is going to take 10 years. A lot of students who go through a program figure out, I really shouldn't be an entrepreneur now because I don't have an original idea. If you copy an idea and start, somebody else will do better than you. What's happening to our Flipkart, Ola, Snapdeal, all of our companies are losing, if you've noticed, to US companies because we did copying models. We never created the original model. And the source of that information is what we are trying to do at AICT policy. We have to help our kids do original thinking. We can't copy anymore. We will fail as a nation if we try to copy. So original thinking, we have to start at college. Our goal is at least get the college ecosystem going so that eventually we can go to school and tell the school kids, start at Instagram. That's the final goal.
So sir has put it very nicely, but I am more of a practical person. So what I thought is, just let us take the question of our projects, okay? How do all of us, if we are teachers, you know how we evaluate our projects. Let us change the evaluation parameters. Let us look at, if you are given a project, see which industry will use it, who is your customer, how should I modify it to satisfy my customer. These things are never part of our evaluation process. If we can bring this into our evaluation process, it's a starting point of not even an idea, making the student think differently. That's what I'm saying. That much, I think, is possible. Just change your, all of us together can come up with a framework of how a project should be evaluated, assuming projects are done by the students.
Now, one last, I think we'll end with this question, Minathi. Yeah, please, Doctor.
Good evening. Good evening, dignitaries, on off the ash. We are discussing about the central repository of ideas. My question is to EDA, why not we conduct some regional workshops at different locations in Tamil Nadu with MSMEs to collect their issues and we'll add it to the repository so that students will take it as a project and the students can get a different mentoring support and they may get a support for their prototyping and some input supplement technology may also emerge over.
I think it's a brilliant idea. In fact, we are in the exploratory phase. In fact, we found a very interesting thing. I think this is a thought I'll share. I was trying to browse the internet to find out where are these repositories of problem statements, you know. So, incidentally, I found one, the Indian Machine Tool Manufacturers Association. They have set up a website called Industry Institute Collaboration, where they have allowed institutes as well as industries to register themselves. And industry have posed a lot of problems, and I could find it a very close cousin of what we are trying to do, you know. So I guess maybe, as you rightly said, we'll get the industry associations involved along with institutes, and probably we'll do regional workshops, and it may also do a lot of good. Like for instance, industry association getting to know the institutes better, and maybe start up a good collaboration phase and all that stuff. Certainly, yes.
Excuse me, sir. Shall I have one more question? I would like to discuss about one important fact which I have experienced when I met with the students. My one honest question to Mr. Sanjay sir. So when you stepped into NSS Engineering College in Palakkad, which is totally rural based, how many students did you find that they have really known about the word, meaning of the word startup?
So very few actually. Okay, and that is where the whole community architect, that Hare Krishna character, became super important. I'll tell you exactly how this happened. Right. So one, the local success story happened. So in every college, there are some students who are like smart, who will know. So NSS has an average of around 2,000-2,500 engineering students. 600 is the approximate intake per year. Right. Now, once the one kid became successful, everybody started to know something happened and he became successful. The second thing happened was this student called Hare Krishna, who was the engine and the catalyst in that college, he informed everybody that Startup Village was conducting a session in college. So I told, right, we had applications from 45 engineering colleges in Tamil Nadu. We did the campaign only in Kerala. Okay. We went to some 20 engineering colleges out of the 140 engineering colleges. The word spreads online, WhatsApp, Facebook, students talk, somehow they get to know. We had applications from 26 states, some 226 universities applied to the program for a campaign that ran only in Kerala.
I asked how many students, out of 2,500 students, how many students were able to know what is the meaning of the word startup?
Very few.
That is the actual fact now. Even the faculty members, we do not know what is the meaning of the word startup. We cannot distinguish business and startup. This is the case. Whatever the skills and knowledge the faculty members are collectively having, that is only will be transformed to the students community. If faculty members are totally unaware of it, then the kids who have to be creative and have to blossom in their life, just before like what you have said, they are being guided in a many different directions by many faculty members. They are totally confused and we are also totally confused. So we need orientation about what is startup, what is IPR, what are all the entrepreneurial opportunities we have and what are the funding agencies we have. Like usually AACT is conducting IST workshop through ICT days. If you will be able to do it for entrepreneurial workshop for the faculty members of engineering, let us first understand what is the current scenario, what is the future scope for this entrepreneurial. Then only we can motivate the students. That should be a collective work needs to be done. It cannot be individually done by the ESL coordinator. ESL coordinator is 360 degree, we are struggling. We cannot manage the students. We cannot ask the faculty to allow the students for attend the motivation program and seminar. So we need help and guidance from you. Thank you.
Actually,
word partnership, right? And networking. See, a lot of these work, number one, I would like to say that let the entrepreneurship activity be a student activity. I think you should not try to do everything. If you try to do that, I think that's not your work. Your job is to actually facilitate and give an enabling environment, the freedom, the ability to link up with other resources. And then I'm sure that they will all do. I think you have to, as you rightly say, identify those 2-3 guys, you know, who are very smart enough. And give them the freedom to innovate. I think they will do a lot more than what you ever dream of. So that is number one. Second thing is that build partnerships. That's what I'm saying. Bring in your alumni. Why are you doing it? Bring your alumni who is probably running a smart business just about 20 kilometers down the road. So bring all these people in. You will be able to give a multiplier effect of say 10 or 100. So that is what I think you should do. I think instead of this model of delivering this to the campuses should change from faculty-led model to a partner-led model and a student-led model. I think that will succeed better than probably anything else.
Just to add to that, so I fully empathize with what you're saying.
Okay.
And see, the change that happened in Kerala didn't happen like in 1 year. The message, so this campaign that we're starting now, right, it is not like a one-off event. Like the Android version will come, you will see follow-up events and things happening. Continuously, when the message keeps going is when the pen-sitters start thinking, something is really happening. It's not like this one blowing, suddenly somebody thought, you know, I'm doing a new AICT policy. It's not. It's a carefully thought out planned program that will come. You will see follow-up programs from EDI. It will happen in hubs where more faculty will be brought in. The sessions would change. The sessions would change on how the faculty can understand this better, how the faculty can communicate this better. Then you will see sessions happening only for students in colleges and then large events for colleges. For example, in Kerala, our largest event has like 5,000, 6,000 students coming.
Okay.
And those sessions are completely different. Those are exactly prototyping, how do I get customer, who is the investor, where is money. So the topic of discussions keep changing. So to reassure you continuously, A, we empathize with you, we understand it. If you can clearly give us feedback, we at AICT are happy to create particular sessions tailored for faculty training. In fact, get you certified from AICT as an AICT certified faculty trainer, because that improves your credentials in college as well, right? And then with the support of EDI, you will see follow-up sessions happening inside colleges. And the crux towards the whole thing, finally after you realize is, the final delivery has to be a partner-led model. Because the role of university and the role of academia is completely different from what the industry is doing. And you shouldn't try to do both. And the industry shouldn't try to do what academia is doing. Each person should stick to its core competency. We need this bridge. And this bridge is what currently is missing in India. The moment we create the bridge, all the students who want to run and cross will cross. All the students who don't want the bridge will not take the bridge. Let's just create the bridge and see what happens.
We can write to startup at AICTIndia.org.
I would like to distinguish the difference between MSME and startup. At least you must know this. The basic difference is innovation. Innovation is the key. You should have novelty, inventive step, and applications. What is the use of this? Or why you are recognized as a startup? What is the difference between the others and this? Let us say you have a new idea. Let us say this pen, your innovation is there. If you are protected with IP, intellectual property, nobody cannot think about that idea for 20 years. 20 years, you can be the monopoly in the market. That is the difference between the other process and the startups. That is what Honorable Prime Minister was brought this idea. To protect their invention for our innovation for 20 years. That is basic difference between them.
So,
yes, yeah, please.